How's it going, everyone? I hope you all have been doing well. NDSean45 here. Well, after another little hiatus, I am back. And I know it seems like I'm not on video much these days anymore, but sometimes that's just how it goes. And besides, my off-seasons, I'm really not that much active on here anyway, aside from a little video now and then, but I've just had a lot going on in my life lately, and I just really have not had the time to get on here and make videos as much as I'd like to, but I'm sure most of you all know how that goes. But anyway, I just wanted to get on here and talk a little bit about this year's 2012 Blue and Gold game. Now, to be honest with you guys, I don't really know how fair it is that you can judge the state of a college football team based on all these spring games. Mainly because a lot of the guys are still trying to shake out all the off-season cobwebs. In our case at Notre Dame, we have a lot of question marks at a lot of the positions, most notably quarterback and corner. And you know, there's just a lot of experimentation going on with personnel and all that. And last and certainly not least, the most obvious factor: you're playing yourself. I mean, now don't get me wrong, I'm not saying that guys don't play hard in these games and that they don't compete or anything like that, but it's not the same as if you're getting ready for, say, a USC or a Michigan or an Oklahoma, so on and so forth, you know what I mean? But anyway, just for what it's worth, I just wanted to talk a little bit about the Blue and Gold game this year and what all took place and where I think this team is going. Now, for starters, the big thing that stuck out to me from Saturday was our running game. It was nice to see Sierra Wood have a great day, pretty much pick up from where he left off last season, just very explosive. Theo Riddick, it was nice to see him in action and just getting all over the place, making plays left and right. And obviously the big standout running back for us was George Atkinson III. 115 yards in the first half alone. I believe he finished with 121, 54 receiving yards. Great day for him. But obviously the only downside to his performance were the two fumbles that he had. And, you know, you don't have to be a Notre Dame fan to know that last season, turnovers killed us. 29 overall last season, and on Saturday we saw 6 more. And you know, after last season, that's not something that you want to see. But nonetheless, George Atkinson III, he had a real nice game, and I'm confident that he will, you know, get his fumbleitis cured. So it's very important that George, you hang on to the ball, because I really do think this guy can be an explosive running back for us. Very nice compliment to Sierra Wood. Also on the offensive side of the ball was our receiving corps. Tyler Eifert, great performance. He needs no explanation. He is going to be a big key receiver this year for us, a big go-to guy, same as what he was last year. But as far as the wide receivers go, even though he didn't have a lot of catches, I love the play of Devaris Daniels. Great athletic ability, great hands. I'm not saying he's going to be the next Michael Floyd, but he is right now in the makings to be a big-time playmaker, and I think that's exactly what he's going to be. He just needs the right kind of quarterback thrown to him, but I'll get to that a little bit later on in this video. Let's see. Who else really stood out? Defensive side of the ball. Now, I know a lot of people have been talking with, the big recent news being the departure of defensive end Aaron Lynch. Now, I would be lying through my teeth if I said that Aaron Lynch leaving us was no big deal whatsoever. I mean, losing him sucks big time, especially with his pass rushing ability. And I'm not just saying this because I'm a Notre Dame fan, but last season I think he had, and still and currently is, the best pass rusher in the game right now in all of college football. He just has a certain pass rushing dynamic explosiveness that is really going to be missed by this defensive line. But despite that, I was really happy with what I saw in guys like Kona Schwenke, Stefan Tuitt, Lewis Nix, Jaron Grace. Really happy to with how those guys stepped up and made plays. So defensive line, I'm not, even with the departure of Lynch, I'm not overly concerned at, because I think we have a lot of playmakers there, and we're going to be just fine even without Aaron Lynch being there. So I have confidence in our guys, but does losing Lynch suck? Yeah, absolutely it does. What also really impressed me on defense was the play of Ishaq Williams at linebacker. He was stepping up all day long, making plays, had an interception. I believe he also recovered a fumble. He was just all over the place, and I think he's going to have a breakout season this year. So look out for Ishaq Williams. Now, other than the quarterback situation, which even that I'm not overly concerned at, the one aspect of the Notre Dame football team right now that I'm really concerned at is our cornerback situation. You know, we obviously the big talk in the off season was T. Shepherd departing. You know, a big 4-star recruit that we pulled in left school after 8 weeks. But that was under different circumstances, though, because he has some heart problems going on. And, you know, I wish him all the best, as I do Lynch as well. You know, T. Shepherd was just a case of, hey, you know, pardon my French, but shit happens. You know, nothing you can do about that. But as it stands, we only have 4 scholarship cornerbacks. And I'm really not sure what to expect, because a lot of those guys don't really have a lot of experience at this level. I know Bennett Jackson has one spot nailed down already, and he didn't even play on Saturday. But I've liked what I've seen out of him from seeing the practice videos. And as far as the other cornerback spot opposite him, I was really impressed with how all those guys stepped up. You know, Josh Atkinson, even Austin Collinsworth and Cam McDaniel. They did a pretty damn good job holding their ground on Saturday. Now, honestly, in my opinion, just based on, you know, what I've seen so far, I think the second cornerback spot is going to come down to a battle between Josh Atkinson and Lo Wood. And I have Lo Wood taking the starting job in the end. But I definitely expect Josh Atkinson to give Lo a run for his money. But I just think it's going to be whoever can stay the most consistent. And that's where I think Lo Wood has a little bit of the upper edge on Josh Atkinson. But, you know, hey, it's all a work in progress. Nothing with Notre Dame surprises me these days. Now, the big topic that everyone's waiting for, the quarterback situation.
There can be only one.
How's that for a segment intro? But with this quarterback battle, it's been very fitting. There can be only one. But honestly, with the way things are right now, I think we're going to see multiple quarterbacks on the field this year. Now, just like I said in the beginning of this video about judging players based on the spring game, I don't think you can fairly do it. But for what it's worth, from what I saw on Saturday with the four candidates, Tommy Rees, Andrew Hendricks, Everett Golson, Gunnar Kiel, Tommy Rees, I didn't see any improvement whatsoever there. I was still seeing the same old Tommy that we saw last season. He's still taking way too long, zoning in on his receiver, and it's causing him to make mistakes and make some bad throws. And it showed with the interception that he threw. Andrew Hendricks, he's still not looking completely comfortable out there. I mean, he had some nice throws in the... I know he only saw 15 reps, but he did have some nice throws, and he did have the one touchdown pass to Tyler Eifert. But he's still not looking completely comfortable out there. And the interception that he threw, it was very similar to the one that he threw in the Champ Sports Bowl. Right at the defender, you know? So there's nothing really much more I can say about Andrew Hendricks when it comes to that. Everett Golson, as we all saw, was definitely the standout quarterback. You know, he had a nice day throwing the ball, 11 of 15, 120 yards, two touchdowns. He looked very impressive out there. But just like the other three candidates, he had plenty of mistakes himself. You know, he put a couple of balls on the ground, which cannot happen, which I can't stress enough, going back to protecting the football. You know, we have to protect that football like it's our life. But at least he was able to get him back. But still, you know, he looked confused out there. You know, as Brian Kelly even said in his press conference, and I'm sure any of you who watched the game could tell, he looked very confused out there. He was having trouble reading the signals from the sidelines. He was having trouble getting everyone set up. And, you know, it came back to bite him in the butt a little bit. You know, it forced him to burn two timeouts in the first quarter. And if that was an actual game, that's inexcusable. You can't burn two timeouts in the first quarter. You have to get your crap together. Gunnar Kiel, you know, there's not really much I can say about him because, you know, even though he was a highly touted quarterback, you know, five-star quarterback out of high school, he's still a college freshman, and he's still learning the system. But for what it's worth, he did pretty well. 5 of 10 passing, 57 yards. Did have an interception, but, you know, hey, he's young. And to be honest with you guys, and I wouldn't expect Brian Kelly to just come out and say this, but I think they are going to end up redshirting Gunnar Kiel. But who knows? I could be easily wrong about that. But that's just what I see him doing. Now, my opinion is this with the quarterback situation. I think the right candidate is Everett Golson. You know, despite the fact that he has a ways to go yet, he is the right quarterback that we need to run this offense. He's the quarterback that we need in there if we want to win. Now, I know I pointed out all his mistakes earlier, but I honestly believe that if he can get it together, if he can learn that playbook and, you know, get things down to a science and become a leader out there on the field, then look out. We're set with quarterback. We're set with the quarterback spot in that case. Because he has the ability. He has the tools to get it done. He can throw. He can run. Now the only thing left to do is get the mental part of the game down. So if I'm Everett Golson, I am sleeping with that playbook. I am learning the signals to where they become second nature, where I don't even have to think twice about it. With that said, guys, this is NDSean45 signing off. I'll catch you guys later in the next video. Take it easy.